keep them up.
Referee said keep them up. Lee Jordan said keep them up.
Norton came off his feet. It looked like George Patterson on that one. Only his hands are not quite as quick as Patterson.
Middleton, not quite as quick or fresh as he was early in the fight, but he has really fought a good fight against Kenny. Oh, left right combination backs Middleton out of there.
Taking the fight to him, putting the pressure on him, and trying to tire him out with pressure.
When you fought Middleton, you weren't feeling good. I know you felt lousy with your training program and all, but he did take a pretty good punch when you fought him.
Yeah, yes, he did, Tom. He's a very capable fighter. He'll be in there with the best of them. He may not win with the best of them. He'll stay in there.
You get to the level that these two fighters are, there's nobody easy, baby. Getting Norton and all of them. When you get into those top four or five heavyweights, anybody can knock your head off.
Hey, look at big knockout records of men that just are entering into the top 10, and then all of a sudden, no more knockouts. Because, as I've stated earlier, a man didn't get into the top 10 getting knocked out, and they're very difficult to knock out.
Larry Middleton is bleeding about the mouth now. A little bit of that right eye. Still trying to move, but he's not jabbing as much as he did earlier. He's there. He's got to keep that up.
He's got to pump that left hand. He's been bleeding from the mouth in the second round. That right uppercut to Ken Norton.
Round number 8. Middleton now. Not as much offensive as he was, and Norton sort of slowing the pace a little bit, as you can see. 20 seconds left here in this round. Double hook by Norton.
Double hook, both of them blocked by the arm and glove.
Pretty good right hand, sweep right hand, under and over by Middleton.
He's still in the fight. I think he's well behind right now, but he still wants to fight.
Two good jabs and a hook off of it by Kenny Norton. Left right now, off the hook.
Whoa!
Whoa, and they battle at the end of round 8. And Middleton refuses to say, okay, I've done my job for CBS.
Keep your ground.
Gonna hang in there and fight him all the way to the end. Okay.
You gotta give him a lot of credit for that, Tom. He's a very good heavyweight fighter.
Diego Norton against Middleton. And it's been a darn brawling good heavyweight fight. Ninth round.
And Middleton's coming out using the legs again. He's got himself in condition. You have to do the fight somebody like Norton.
You know, he scored with the right-hand lead 4 or 5 times earlier, hadn't he? Is it a dangerous thing, though, Jerry, the right-hand
lead?
Well,
it can be unless you're quick enough with the hands to get away with it.
You just did a disclaimer on me. What you're saying is it is dangerous if you're not real quick, right?
It's extremely dangerous.
Middleton scores inside with a good uppercut with that right hand.
Middleton is already proven he's not a banger. And so, I think at this point the only way he's going to win the fight is to knock out Norton as he slips to the
camera. Hey, you guys are waiting too much. Get a towel and dry that up. You okay?
Was supposed to be in
okay,
there, but they have a firm
you okay?
Footing, but
okay. Let's go.
You know, he did the splits like an acrobat there.
Got back up. Good legs are what he's been living on in his professional boxing. A little low by Norton.
Keep him up, Kenny. Keep him up.
He's warned by the referee for that low blow. I think maybe he thinks because of him slipping over there that the legs are causing him problems.
What about the uppercuts, Jerry? Are they a hard thing to combat if you know somebody can really hit you from underneath?
Well, sometimes they can be hard punches, but mostly they're ripping punches. They can rip your mouth up and eyes and everything else.
Well, this is savage right now, I'll tell you. Kenny Norton now is just saying, okay, hit me, Middleton. I don't think you can hurt
me.
City.
I would say Norton's going to have to do a lot of hard training for that one because he is seeing right now that a man with not near the talent of Ali is
watch
giving
your
him
head.
Trouble.
And move around a lot and give him a lot of trouble.
Kenny, what's your hand?
Right, Jerry Quarry.
The hands of Muhammad Ali are extremely faster than Larry Middleton. And yet Middleton has hit Norton kind of what he wanted to today.
Kenny Norton is a very positive man. He has no fear of Muhammad Ali, and I guess Muhammad knows that. Strange how one guy seems to have a little hex over you and somebody else you want to go in.
No. Is that the bell?
It's corner. 17 seconds still left.
Don't pull on his head. Don't pull on his head.
From the other side of the opportunity, the Coliseum.
Middleton Middleton coming back and staying inside. Oh, Norton is hit with the body part.
Left into the body partially low.
Rudy Jordan, the referee, is talking constantly, warning both fighters on a personal basis, I might add. There's the real bell.
Belly.
Round number 10, live from San Diego, Tom Brookshire and Jerry Quarry. And the two people you see are Kenny Norton on the right and Larry Middleton on the left.
You know that Ken's going to try and get him out of here this round. I'll be honest with you, I don't think he can do it, Tommy.
Well, you said this would go 10 rounds, and we all could have laughed at you, Quarry, but you're right. It's going to go into the 10.
One thing I do know, Tommy, is I do know fighters.
CBS knows a good attraction. This is live to you, and I'm telling you, these two have been at it since they started 10 rounds ago.
It's been a great heavyweight bout, and something the people really like to see.
Oh, slipped down again. Middleton did it his own foot.
You okay?
He's up all right. He's got him up.
In the same corner, he slipped to his knee.
Go ahead.
Kenny Norton,
get some rosin from over there and put it on
Middleton
there.
Goes right back in there and gets close.
As the referee told the cornerman to put some rosin in that corner so he didn't slip again.
Get some rosin
Kenny
and put it on there.
Always knew where Middleton was, though, right in front of him. He didn't back off too much.
This man has been here. Now, there's no way.
All right, don't pull. Whoa.
Than a punch.
I think Kenny's a little upset with his performance.
I think Kenny might be a little tired himself, but he's such a rugged customer, he's going to be able to accomplish it. It's just not quite as much of a perfection job as he would like to see. Boy, he's strong still.
That he is, but let me tell you, he's going to have to be a heck of a lot better than this to handle himself with L.A.
You think Ali is watching?
Don't
right
pull
now?
On his head,
you know
man.
He is.
I bet you Joe Frazier's watching, too.
I'll bet George Foreman, Joe Frazier, Wayne Bobick, all of them are watching.
Larry Middleton is staying on his feet, and he refuses to go down. And he pulled up. He's locked again.
He's cut.
Bleeding at the mouth. Rudy Jordan's looking him over, and Norton is working on him and hitting Norton's corner.
Cut in the left corner of his mouth.
Middleton dances out and asks for nothing. Norton now has to have it stopped.
No, he stops about in the 10th round. I really don't think that was right, Tom.
Well, Middleton had gone too far to have it called in the 10th.
I think so. And the people are throwing their plastic cups and everything else in the ring. Going up to Tom Brookshire in the ring.
All right,
he's
Jerry.
Going to be interviewing the winner.
31.
La primera vez. Quarter pound. Jenny record de 20.